All right, today I'm going to be comparing the Suicide Squad to Guardians of the Galaxy. I say the Suicide Squad for you guys not to get confused about the 2016 version. This video is going to be more about the evolution of James Gunn or the regression of James Gunn's career. So I found this random image on Google, and I feel like it breaks down movies enough. I do want to preface this by saying that I really enjoyed both of the movies. They were very good movies, but I thought it would be fun to just compare them to see how a filmmaker changes or does things for whatever reason. I did like both movies a lot, which is like the only reason I'd actually compare them. All right, let's start off with the setting and the atmosphere. With The Suicide Squad, we have a tropical beach that has tons of life and vegetation, and it just feels very fun. We also go to the fictional city of a fictional city in Latin America. In the Guardians of the Galaxy, we have a very colorful and vibrant space with tons of different locations. There's like futuristic cities, there's space battles, you got that one prison scene. I'm gonna give the setting to Guardians of the Galaxy, but I'm gonna give the atmosphere to the Suicide Squad. And just because it feels very vibrant and the city feels lived in, it feels very grounded and like this could actually happen, which brings up the stakes, but we'll get more into that later. The cinematography is a pretty tough one comparing the two. They both have good cinematography, but the Suicide Squad has more style and more in-your-face camera work. There's constant zooms. The Guardians of the Galaxy feels more basic in a way. The color grade is a lot more vibrant on Suicide Squad. It's more contrasty. And speaking on the actual movement of the camera and its purpose, looking at both of them, they actually are very similar, like shot composition and like all like the little minute details. You can tell they're both directed by the same person, which is kind of interesting. But just on the fact that Suicide Squad it feels more bold. What would normally be done in words, instead of writing it out in a simple plain text, the title is in the environment. It's actually like in the scene, which I thought was a cool touch. It speaks to how unapologetic this film is. I'm gonna give lighting to Suicide Squad pretty like clearly, because natural light always just comes out way better than artificial light. Like the prison scene almost seems dull in comparison because of the artificial lighting. You just can't beat the sun. Like it looks like a set. Like it doesn't look as good. Like in the wide shots it looks alright. A lot of the Suicide Squad are shot on beaches or daytime outside. Very little of it takes place indoors. And on top of that, like in the nighttime shots, you've got fire and you got like these natural lights. Obviously they have like other lights, but like visually, easily goes to Suicide Squad. Next we have clothing and decor. This one also is like easily for the Guardians of the Galaxy. And the costumes are cool, space costumes, but it's also like not done too much. It's not like super flashy and it's not like overdone. It's really like, it reminds me of like Star Wars-esque, but not really, kind of, sort of. But Suicide Squad also does have like really cool costumes. Idris Elba's character has pretty like boring design. But then again, like they all seem pretty simple and basic, and it almost reinforces the fact that they are disposable and that they could die at any moment. Actually, but I think I've convinced myself. I had a pretty good point. They do look kind of generic. This may have been like an intentional choice. Like John Cena looks very basic, just like every other superhero. Because reinforcing the fact that these people are very disposable and don't matter. Now, I think I'm gonna give it to Suicide Squad. Like, the fact that it's like tying into the idea of the film is pretty neat. I don't think I ever said that pretty neat. They go, what? The pace of the film. This is actually a pretty hard one because they're both, in my opinion, they both have pretty good pacing. I think I am still going to give it to Guardians of the Galaxy due to the fact that it's way more efficient in its storytelling. Like, I think that first introduction was like 2 minutes and it told us everything we needed to know. Like, it told us that Peter Quill is not emotionally mature. It told us that his mom died, and it told us he ran away and ended up in space somehow, all in like 2 minutes. Very rapid. But I do like that Suicide Squad has slower pacing because it lets you like sit with the characters more. But I'm gonna have to give it to Guardians of the Galaxy. Suicide Squad wins suspense by a landslide. The thing that made this movie so great is that it really emphasized the fact that these people did not matter. They could live or die. It does not matter. Like, there's a lot of death in this movie. No one is safe. People actually died. There's actual tension in certain scenes. Also, the film's rated R and it gets pretty gory. Like, people get their heads blown off. It's still not like very suspenseful compared to like other movies, but for a superhero film, way better. In Guardians of the Galaxy's defense, damn, I got nothing. I thought I was gonna think of something there, but nah. It's almost unfair comparing like a hard R, well, almost hard R film to a Marvel movie. It almost seems like pedestrian in comparison. Damn, these are big words, big words. But yeah, easily Suicide Squad. Sound and music is pretty difficult just because they both use music really well. The Suicide Squad establishes like this idea that when the music is like in the audio mix and it's like loud, it's, we're almost in like this fantasy land. They do it beautifully with Harley Quinn. Once it becomes actually in the scene, it's almost like we're out of this like surreal fantasy world. However, Guardians of the Galaxy does have the music's tied into the storyline and can't be story, but that, yeah, you can't be storytelling the way like it's his mom's recorder. I'm gonna have to give it to Guardians of the Galaxy. Editing, from my videos, you can tell I know nothing about editing, but I'm gonna just give it to Guardians of the Galaxy, mainly because it's getting stomped right now. Let's give it like a pity point. It has better pacing. I feel like Suicide Squad does like try things more. Like, there's a couple of jump cuts, time lapses. I'm gonna just give it to Guardians of the Galaxy. Character. The character writing in both these films are excellent. They all like tie into their themes. They both have similar themes, especially the main character, Bloodshot, was it? My bad. Bloodsport does have a pretty similar story to Peter Quill in that he needs to learn to, or even like all the characters of Guardians of the Galaxy. Most of them, aside from Groot, all need to learn to open up, and they do that to one another. And yeah, and like everything feels very tied in together, but the Suicide Squad has a more variety of characters. Like, you got the fact that I cared about a character called Ratcatcher 2. It's a testament to James Gunn's writing. It's pretty brilliant. She's the perfect counter to Bloodsport in that she just loves all animals and she just loves like all living, breathing things. And she's very like, is very kind to all things and is very understanding. A shark tried to eat her and then like, 5 seconds later, isn't even mad. Almost died in her sleep. Not even mad. But like, that's the kind of person her father raised her to be. And then the father dynamic, it's very good. I am gonna give it to Guardians of the Galaxy just because while I love Bloodsport, I thought Peter Quill as a main character, he's definitely the main character of the film and there's more of a focus and emphasis on him. And the theme connects to everyone more tightly. Like, everyone works into the themes and of Suicide Squad, and it's like really well done. But it feels more tight in Guardians of the Galaxy. I feel like that's what you get working with Marvel. Everything is like very precise and neatly done. It's almost like a formula, like a machine They just know exactly what to do and how to do it. And like, it's like a machine. It always just pumps out good movies or decent movies. The next thing on our list is acting. Acting is kind of tough in these superhero movies because everyone just does a good job. They always hire the best talent. Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn carries like crazy. But then you have John Cena. Well, you can tell he's trying his best, but like, he's just not like that good of an actor. I love that they got Vin Diesel to play Groot. He literally just has to say one word. He does a great job. He says that one word. But I'm gonna still give it to Suicide Squad. Idris Elba is just like good at his job. So I'm gonna just give it to Suicide Squad. I feel like the plot easily goes to the Suicide Squad because it's pretty interesting. Like having expendable characters that could die at any minute. It's a cool concept. With Guardians of the Galaxy, you have bounty hunters, space bounty hunters, and we've seen that a ton of times. And like, his ragtag team needs to save the universe. Quill must rally his ragtag group to save the universe. It's cool. It's not a bad plot. I don't know. This is easily a Suicide Squad. Narrative structure. I am going to give narrative structure to Suicide Squad. I did like that it just does these side jumps to where it jumps into the past. It jumps around a lot. I thought that was interesting. Guardians of the Galaxy has a pretty standard plot structure. It's very simple. To be honest, both the films are very simple in the narrative structure, but it's definitely Suicide Squad. Speaking on the action, the Suicide Squad's action is way better. Like, maybe it's not way better, but like, it's pretty good. Like, that scene with Harley Quinn, that's some good stuff right there. That's good. I can't lie. The next thing on our list is the themes of the film. This is almost unfair because they both have very similar themes. But Suicide Squad does have that anti-establishment side to it. And there's not much to say here, but yeah. They both have themes of family, learning to love one another, to like open up to one another, moving forward, being more emotionally mature like Harley Quinn. And yeah, I'm really trying to think of an argument for Guardians of the Galaxy, but that's the thing that Guardians of the Galaxy does better in my opinion. Its themes are a lot less, so it's a lot tighter and it's a lot more tied in together. But overall, more themes, more better. I don't know. It's not, yeah, I'm giving it Suicide Squad. And our final score comes in at 9-5. Not the job. I mean, I did think The Suicide Squad was a better film. Obviously, Guardians of the Galaxy held up. Good fight. It went the distance. It tried its best. At the end of the day, the victor has come. The film that's low-key carrying all of the DCEU, The Suicide Squad. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you disagree with me, just leave a comment. Even if you want to yell at me. Don't forget to subscribe, leave a like, and all that stuff. You know the deal. But yeah, those are just my thoughts. Just my opinions. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on TikTok. I don't know. I might post. Maybe. Who knows? Whatever. Bye.